Leads to another Game Order production.
I actually started playing this back when it came out. And just kind of didn't keep up with it. Didn't plan on doing all the secrets, but since we've been on a Doom roll, more or less, I figured, what the hell? Let's go ahead and wrap it up. We've done Doom. Brutal Doom, rather. All the four episodes that entail with that. Done. Doom 2. And currently are finishing up with No Rest for the Living. Done Doom 3. Both of its expansions. And now it's time to fuck up some Doom 2016. Good ol' Hurt Me Plenty.
They are rage, brutal, without mercy. But you will be worse. Rip and tear until it is done.
Welcome to the ghetto, bitch! I got about a fucking gun. Oh yeah! I came to kick ass and chew gum! And I'm all out of gum. Motherfucker. Alright, so here we are, folks. Doom 2016. Fucking phenomenal graphics.
We have to contain this.
You can contain my nuts, bitch. Doom Trooper has been reborn. Welcome to my hell.
Recently got the board game that's a representation of this particular take on Doom. I plan on bringing a playthrough of it to YouTube sometime this year.
Welcome. I'm Dr. Samuel Hayden. I'm the head of this facility. I think we can work together and resolve this problem in a way that benefits us both.
So we'll be going over all the codecs, basically. Probably a lot of playthroughs on YouTube of this already. However, they probably stick more to the action and less to the I'm in a mind fart. Been a long day at work, but the background, the story, and the actual content of the game itself.
So we'll be kind of going over the codex as things pop up. First thing, the Praetor suit. Additional relics were found in the tomb alongside the Doom Marine. Some incantation tablets and an ancient combat suit which was given the name the Praetor suit. When found, it was encased in an inscribed stone tomb. The suit was extracted from the rock, cleaned, and subjected to numerous tolerance tests, found to be almost impervious to any damage. It appeared to have some mechanical function as well, small receptors on the gloves and chest plate that attracted Argent plasma and dissipated through the capillary tubes in the substructure. Markings on the armor were also consistent with images of a man or a humanoid seen in several of the tablets and stones found on other expeditions. The same markings were also noted on the Helix stone. Despite it being clear that the suit can be activated in some way, no method has been found to do it. It appears to be a missing component, likely the Doom Marine himself. Under weapons, we have the pistol, the UAC MG sidearm. Every UAC employee is provided a standard UAC Energy Matter Gel sidearm upon promotion to Tier 2 and above. The sidearm is reliable and effective at short range. Gravity gear dynamo in the stock charges a capacitor whenever the operator moves. When the weapon is fired, the capacitor compresses up to 4 megawatts of Argent energy into a hardened plasma gel and launches the slug at high velocity. The gel slug has same impact properties as conventional ammunition, making the weapon act and feel like a standard ballistic firearm. The weapon is constructed of thermally diffusive metal alloys, which allow it to discharge rapidly and repeatedly without overheating or compromising the accuracy. The capacitor and the EMG can also be upgraded to concentrate the energy into one large pulse for more stopping power. You can see kills that you've gotten with each weapon over here. We also have our weapon upgrade screen, our armor upgrade screen for our Praetor suit, and different weapons and things that we will be unlocking throughout the game. I will most likely do each episode, or rather each mission, will be one complete video, regardless of length. So expect videos that will go longer than 30 minutes. And of course we have the good old glory kills. They kind of help you heal in this game. Whoa, fucking dude looking grody. Welcome to the grody ghetto. Combat shotgun. The UAC shotgun disperses a spread of high-velocity buckshot for maximum impact against the enemy, ideally suited for the operative who requires a speedy response for deadly close encounters. The wide coverage of this weapon loses impact at long range. The weapon is forged from a high-quality titanium steel alloy to ensure maximum reliability, repeat rate, and yield strength. The possessed are created in a Lazarus wave event, phenomenon first discovered by Dr. Olivia Pierce during her Lazarus project. While most victims exposed to Argent biowaves will expire without further effects, some subjects will absorb traces of Argent energy and enter in a state of posthumous vigor. Despite necrosis of the internal organs, with the exception of the brain, the victim continues to animate and exhibit a low order of sentience for weeks or even months after clinical death. Posthumous brain activity in the possessed is limited to instinctive behavior. The possessed are known to be territorial when confronted by the living. When isolated, they will often enter a dormant state for extended periods of time. They will stand unmoving for days or weeks at a time until presented with a live food source or threatened by a predator. An interesting behavior has been seen when the possessed are held in small groups. They will drag human corpses to a central location within their holding pens and then perform a silent ritual around a pile of bodies. The resulting ceremonial site appears to be the initial stages of a gore nest. These actions must be driven by a telepathic communication with higher-ranking demons, as there is no local brain activity that can manage such choices. The possessed will perform these tasks even when limbs are removed, or Pavlonian pain responders are implemented in their cortex,
further cementing the theory that they are unwilling slaves performing an integral part of life cycle of the demons. The possessed create the birthing ground for new demons, and upon expiration are themselves used as fertilizer for the gore nest. And Glory Kales, we won't be going over the tutorial too much because that's part of playing the game anyways. Also have our mission tab here, where we can check out the map. And you can see collectibles and different things that appear there. And we have the good old flame throwing imps. Lockdown in effect. These ferocious and agile demons are found all over Hell and are often used as the front line in concerted attack in either dimension. They revel in battle, feeding off their victims when the hunger takes them. Fair enough. But I will warn you, the ghetto hunger has taken the game order. And I gotta fuck your gore nest up, baby. Sorry about your luck.
Demonic presence at unsafe levels. Lockdown in effect.
Demonic presence at unsafe levels. Lockdown in effect.
You can go for a fucking trip!
Demonic presence eliminated. Lockdown disengaged.
Not really rushing this at all, just trying to show you guys all the nice graphics and hopefully a couple cool Easter eggs. And you gotta blow up the fucking barrels. You have the good old jumping and climbing skill in this, which is a little bit different than what you're used to in a Doom game.
He cannot be allowed to leave this place. He will ruin everything.
Too bad, bitch.
I'm willing to take full responsibility for the horrible events of the last 24 hours, but you must understand. Our interest in their world was purely for the betterment of mankind. Everything has clearly gotten out of hand now, yes. But it was worth the risk, I assure you.
Welcome, Hordelines, to Bethesda production, an in production, and a fucking game for a production of Doom. Now, if this game has anything going for it besides beautiful fucking graphics, it's a beautiful fucking soundtrack. Our new mission is to get the fuck out of Dodge and also find the resource ops entrance. There are three secrets on this level. Let's get them. But first,
I must refill my beer.
Dossier. I got a dossier.
Gornesk. Studies of demons upon entering this dimension have shown that their conduct is not purely vindictive. There is a method behind their actions. When a demon captures their prey, the fresh kill is taken to a temporary ceremonial site where arcane rituals are performed on the pile of blood and gore. When enough corpses have been gathered, the ceremonial site becomes a gore nest. These sites, imbued with hell's energy from the rituals, act as umbilical cords to hell. Extreme caution must be taken when approaching a gore nest. Attacking the nest, or indeed any demons within close proximity to the nest, will act as an alarm and siphon more demons from hell.
Yeehaw! Fucking Doom Trooper. I don't take fall damage, baby. So here's our very first data log. A brief history. Despite the discovery of liquid water on Mars in the early 21st century, the colonization of Mars had little appeal beyond exploration for the next century. The discovery of the Argent Fracture, a transdimensional stream of unrefined Argent plasma, in 2095, settling and mining Mars became both practical and essential to meet the vast energy of demands of Earth. However, the need for atmospheric conversion and terraforming of the Red Planet was a task that seemed insurmountable to all but one corporation, the UAC. Through the diligent dedication of the technological advancement and forward thinking, an outpost was established in MTC 2096 to extract Argent plasma from the Fracture. When the plasma is subjected to UAC Fermionic Transference Pattern, Argent Energy is produced. This remarkable venture eventually bore fruit as Argent Energy became the primary power source for all of Earth. New visitors to the UAC facility may take for granted the rich atmosphere while on the surface, but it should be remembered that just a few short decades ago, Mars was an inhospitable desert that could support no life. And now what supports this life? Our mission indicator, which is showing us our distance. Off in the distance, we can see a imp jump off the cliff like a little bitch. And we can see the dead. Getting fucked up from a distance. You can also do a charge shot if you hold down your mouse button. Shoot demons in their asses. Cause immense amounts of fucking pain. Anyways, let's get down here. You know what the deal is, folks. It's time to ride or die. Fuck you! Whoa, dude. You got messed up. So what I like to do is run around in circles and just be crazy. Hey, fat boy! Testicle protection testicles. You got fucked up.
you think you're going, buddy?
Not that direction.
She doesn't look so hot. That's better. Now let's fuck. Just kidding, I don't have sex with dead bodies. Only partially dead.
Alright, get some armor shards. Definitely some of that shit.
Right. Blue access key. One thing I love about this game is it harkens back to the old feeling of the Doom style, getting different colored access keys to continue through the levels. It's not completely linear at all, which is nice. They've kind of left a little bit of open-endedness to the levels. You won't be needing that anymore. Let's go ahead and jump up here for our first collectible mini Doom Trooper Man. Secret 2 of 3 right there. And we got our frag grenade, which is rechargeable. You can see there in the bottom right hand side we have the grenade icon indicator filling back up.
You got fucked up. Welcome to the ghetto.
Enough for me.
You got fucked up, all of you.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's time for the shit show.
This is the map download. It's always good to have the auto map. You can kind of zoom out and see exactly where everything is. Shows you where the elite guards, field drones. No challenges on this particular mission, but they will be enabled. I won't be trying too hard to get them. I'll just try. We also have our upgrade system here, which we don't have any points to upgrade yet. We'll get to that when we need to. The frag grenade, the design of this weapon, is conventional in nature, though it's been refined to perform the limit of its ballistic capabilities. The UAC fragmentation grenade uses a COMD explosive package encased in a steel alloy shell and has the effective fatality radius of about 5 fucking meters. Improvements on the antiquated M67 grenade include a more reliable chemical fuse mechanism. Interior
machining of the casing to provide more efficient projectile dispersion, and a trigger switch safety clip to prevent unwanted activation. The newer CompDee explosive also ensures the radio pressure wave has no drop spots, ensuring full damage potential within the fatality show. The proper way to pronounce this when you're not a drunk, stuttering fucking moron is antiquated, by the way. Sometimes when I'm reading, I fumble a little bit with my tongue. Possess Soja. While Lazarus Wave exposure does effectively wipe out any vestige of human behavior from most of its victims, some subjects continue to display tactical cognizance posthumously. As with possessed engineers, this does not appear to be random. If an individual has training in combat as part of the UAC military, the Lazarus Wave event will transform them into more than mere slaves. This anomaly further supports the theory that there is some form of genetic coding embedded within the Lazarus Wave particles, which governs the outcome of Lazarus Wave exposure on a per-case basis. Which basically means the Game Hoarder would turn into a fucking Demon Lord! Just going over the collectibles, secrets, blah 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 blah. Nothing worth giving two fucks about. Oh shit. That guy's had some serious drain damage. I'll take that! So this is the first point we have for our suit. Some of these powers to me are useless. Exploration items, secret sense. We don't really need that because I'm using a fucking wiki to find all the secrets. Some of these can be a little bit better. But in all honesty, the first thing I would normally go for would be to increase the equipment time. So I'm going to go ahead and save that for now. This is probably just talking to us about using points. Oh, the Elite Guard. So who are the Elite Guard? They are a company of security personnel charged with protection of the Lazarus Project research and maintaining order throughout the Argent facility. Their distinct red uniforms help distill a calming influence among UAC employees, and they are known to be level-headed, disciplined, and fair but firm. Their suits contain cybernetic augmentations, which give the Elite Guards an advantage should they need to quell any disturbances. The augmentations allow them to be faster, stronger, and more resilient to energy. Get some of that shit, baby! Fuck you! Fuck you two! And fuck you three! What the fuck? You so crazy! Welcome to the ghetto. Who the fuck are you talking to? You just got spliced. He's ready for a classic throwback. This is my favorite part about this fucking Doom, is that you can go back into old school Doom levels. See what the fuck I'm talking about?
Used to be a secret over here. Don't think it's still there. Pretty cool, though. Like explosive shot. Fuck you, robot. Got a data log. New advocates, welcome to the UAC. This guidebook will serve as your personal guide to fitting in the Argent facility on Mars. Your devotion to the UAC's mission is the foundation on which we achieve the establishment of the new paradigm to move humanity forward into the future. Tier 1 advocates, it may take some time to adjust to life on Mars, but with faith and dedication, you can look forward to a long and fruitful career as your work towards full induction. Your transition to Tier 2 status will be judged upon your actions here. Make a good impression, new advocate. This guide will update automatically as you can access new areas of the facility. Expect more helpful hints into the UAC way of life. And as we say here... learn to fucking scroll down. Okay. Okay, yeah, we got the shotgun explosive shot. Oh, there we go. Now my scroll wheel decided to fucking work. Power from the people. Not power for the people, from the people. So we have the explosive shot. Now we can choose to upgrade that as well. To get cluster bombs, things like that. So let's go ahead and upgrade it. Why not? Shotgun is a versatile weapon. And extremely important in any game of Doom. How gorgeous that landscape looks. Can't wait to fucking destroy all of it. Ooh, dickhead. Oh, shit! Boom shakalaka! Gotcha, bitch! Checkpoint reached, bitches.
got fucked up. Oh, shit! Whoa! Fuck you! That was the last secret that you saw there on the cliff. I just have to remember how to get over to it. There we go. Gives you weapon upgrade points, which are always nice. We need to save up a little bit. Not so sure I want to spend that there yet. Anyways, now that we have all three of the collectibles, you can see right here, shows all three of the question marks filled out. We have the elite guard on this level, the field drones for this level. So we pretty much have 100% of the exploration. Which means, folks, we are clear to leave this level. Sometimes you gotta get some!
Thank you. Welcome to the UAC. Now 221 accident-free days.
Like we give two fucking shits, Bob. I'll see you later, folks. Stay tuned for some more Doom. Soon to come. Rip and tear! Boom shakalaka.